Chelmsford is Essex's only city, given that status by the Queen as part of her Diamond Jubilee in 2012. A few miles outside is a sprawling patch of land, dotted with housing, a number of outbuildings, sheds, and even pigsties. This is where John Giles runs his business as an engineer.
The buildings, they come off of a place called Roxwell Camp, which was rehousing for bombed out people in London. I then bought it in the early 80s, and we've been here ever since, ducking and diving. I'm an engineer. Some people call me a factotum, which means a jack of all trades and a master of none, really. People come up to me and say, can you fix this? And I go, yeah, I can fix it, but that's not the question. Will I fix it?
John's owned the sheds for 30 years, and as this is his first proper clearance, they're full of stuff.
The trouble is, when you've got space, you tend to use it, you know, not very economically sometimes.
Drew will have his work cut out searching all the sheds here. True to his word, Drew is searching absolutely everywhere, regardless of how dirty it is.
I don't think I've ever been asked to look in a pigsty. It's the first time for everything, isn't it?
Going in there?
Yeah.
Want a torch?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Oh, God.
You haven't even got in yet.
I haven't been in it for 20 years.
It looks like it, John, to be honest with you.
Is it like a pigsty in there?
Yeah.
There is genuinely nowhere Drew won't search.
There's all sorts in there. There's a tiny little fiberglass sit-on boat thing. There's loads of old work chairs, but they're all in too bad a condition.
Nothing in there?
No! Apart from an aching Welshman, no.
Every building on John's land is used for a different purpose.
So, is this where you work from then, here, yeah? So what do you do then? Just fix anything?
Anything.
Yeah. And you're busy?
Well, I'm busy enough for me. Yeah. I'm sort of getting to ready for retirement. That's my idea. I've got 12 months to go, so I just want to get this cleared.
You're 64?
Yeah.
You look very well on it.
Thank you.
So now we're in the shed that's sort of the workshop, and he's got an old car under a sheet in here and loads of lathes and welding bits and bobs. Yeah, I just love this shed. I love old sheds like this. What about this? Have you got the rest of the... Is this a job?
It's one of the things we had about here.
And, you got the other wheel?
Yeah, it's there.
Oh. You ever seen that before?
Yeah, shinbusters.
It's a what?
Shinbuster.
A shinbuster?
Yeah, because you walk into him all the time.
On his workbench, he's got a stand for a theatre light in bits, and it looks like it's broken. Reality is he's fixing it, and he's been unseizing it, basically, with loads of old engine oil. Do you want to sell it, John?
Yeah.
Before we go messing about with it?
It really needs to sell.
Cool. I like that. I've never seen that before.
These lamps date from the early 60s and hold two different types of theatrical lighting. At the bottom is a pattern 23 spotlight made by Strand Electric. On the top is this floodlight by Mole Richardson, an American partnership that revolutionized lighting for the film industry and went on to win multiple Oscars. Both lamps contain a Fresnel lens, which help control the light direction and were originally invented for lighthouses. This set could be worth around £600.
I just really like the base. What's it going to cost me?
Bid me.
I'm going to have to wind it back a little bit because of the sheer amount of work. £200?
Yeah, well.
Yeah. Okay. The stand's really nice, and the state that the lights are in, I really like it. They've just dulled off. And then chatting to John, and he said, oh, it's been in the garden for 15 years, and that's where it's got that sort of dull finish to it, which I'd want to keep.
Seaton is a seaside town on the Jurassic coast of Devon. In the 19th century, the railways helped popularise it as a holiday spot. But when the local railway closed in the 1960s, a tramway was built on the disused line. Nearly 50 years later, these antique trams are still running, thanks to enthusiasts like Gareth Richards.
Seaton Tramway here really is a tourist attraction. We attract between 80 and 100,000 visitors a year. We've been here now for this year 47 years.
There are many shelves and cupboards for Drew to search through, piled high with machinery and memorabilia.
Hello there. Quite big, actually. They're pretty cool.
Right, I'm going to have to take a step in towards you.
Ready?
T6, I need to get foot in.
Brilliant, lenses aren't broken.
You got it?
Yeah.
Mind you,
sit caught on.
You're all right, you're all right. Lovely job.
Okay, you got that?
Yeah.
God almighty.
Okay.
Okay, yep. All right.
You good?
I'm glad I put a clean shirt on this morning. Yeah. Yeah, these are great. You don't know where these came from. They're nothing to do with trams, obviously, are they?
No. Siemens, Upper Thames Street, London.
Originally thought to be World War II searchlights, these floodlights actually date from around 1950. They have alloy bodies mounted on gimbals with an iron base. They were manufactured in England by the British arm of Siemens Brothers. Despite the change in provenance, this design is very rare, and they could be worth around £1,500.
What would you like for them? As much as possible, I'm
Absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely.
The good thing is they're a matched pair. They're the same size, the lenses are good, they're on the same bases, and I think they're not even missing a single bit. 400?
The pair.
I would have thought more. 550.
I'll give you 500 quid for the pair, and that's done.
Done?
Yeah, happy, good, thank you. They're fab, aren't they? One of the nicest spotlights of this type I've ever found.
750 then?
Not a chance. I have been into the corners of barns and sheds and lofts and, you know, that was one of the hardest to get into. It was so tricky getting in there, but it's worth it. And to be honest, the only reason they're still here is because they were so difficult to get out.